My name is Vena Chen, and welcome to my studio. And today we're going to paint the birds. And the birds, actually, in the Chinese big category, one is the landscaping, and one is they call the birds and the flower. So that means you know how important the birds play a really big role in Chinese brush painting. So it is very nice us to know the life and the nature of the birds, then we can do better paintings. So today I'm going to introduce simple anatomy and how to do the little birds. I'm going to use a couple little birds such like a sparrow and a swallow. To show you how we do it. Thank you. Today we're going to draw the birds, and I think everybody knows the eggs, the birds come out from the egg. So I just draw egg, then I draw the head. The head is about 1/5 of the body. Of course, the bill and the eye. And I divide the egg into three parts. So usually the wing come out from the first section, the end of the first section, and about 2/3 of the position, that's where the wing come out. And the feet come out the end of the second section and the end. And with three toes in the front, one toe in the back. And here's the tail. That's what the general structure of the birds. And I enlarge the head and the bill. So usually the bottom of the bill is about 1/3 and the top is 2/3. Then I draw a middle line, and that's where the eye position is going to be. And for the crow, so usually you have three toes in the front. And one toe in the back. So when we do the birds, sometimes you can do the head first, sometimes it will happen that we do the bill first. Then we put the eye, then put the head and the back. So I'm going to draw the frame. And here's the tail. Two wings, the bottom. And the crow. So when they fly, the crow is folded. And then I draw one, another fly. So the wing is folded, and then the tail. Then I draw them crow, and they're standing on the branch. that's the crow standing on the vine. That's how you join the birds. You can do the contour style. You do the birds first, then you put the color on or something. So that's the general outline for the birds. Thank you. Now I'm just for use one little bird swallow. So we do show you how to do the swallow. You know, swallow is have a small body, got to have two big wings, and also the tail is like a fork style. And they usually comes in the spring, then they go back to the other place in the fall. They usually come back during springtime. So it's a kind of for the weather birds. So for the swallow, it's a black. So the body, whole body is a black. So we use I use the mixed brush with medium ink. So do the head. Do the head. This is one I going to show you. I do the head first, then I put the bill later, and the eye later. So get the wind down. Got to do two of them. So then I got the head, the back, and the two wings down. Then I use dark ink with the hard brush to do the so-called, they have a feather, they call it a flying feather. So this will be the flying feather. Then also the fork like a tail. See, this one something. Then fork like a tail. Okay. After this, then I use light ink. Use light ink because the chest and the stomach, they supposed to, they're all white color. So I just use the light ink to outline. Just outline the. Just one stroke outline. Okay. Then I use dark ink to do the bill and the eye. Then one thing with the swallow, they have some little color by the throat. So it's kind of remaining color. So I use remaining color and then mix it with a little bit of cinnamon. So that in. Give a little dots here. And also, because they flying, so use dark ink to the little feet. Little crow. So that's usually that's the simple step to the swallow. I just try to add a little bit of color in there for the background. So I I'm going to do a little willow tree. So those is from, it's a green color. So you use indigo mixed with gumbo, then become green color. Willow tree, then it's a springtime, so they supposed to have a flower. So I just use yellow, and you have to use the, I use already, you know, that's why I don't throw any old brush away. Use old brush, then you just step on it. So, stopping a little bit. Use the old brush, that means the flower. Then you use the very light in color to, you always wash a little bit, so that's why the leaves doesn't look too boring. Wash out a little bit. So that's like a simple composition of the background. Then the empty space, Chinese always think you use for sign some, written some letters over there, sign your own name, or sometimes we believe the painting just like a life, you need a breeze. You need some room to breathe. So that's how Chinese do the composition. Thank you. Now I'm going to do another example of the small birds. I'm going to do the sparrow. Yeah, sparrow is a little bird that everybody knows. They're around the house a lot. So they're very small, they have big head. They have the brown wing, and they have a little black dots on the wing, on the body. And this time, I'm going to do the bill first. So I just draw the bill, and the eye, and same thing. And this one, I'm going to do the flying. One bird's flying. So I use a brown color. My burn sierra. Mix with a little black. We do the head first. The head first. And the body. And the two wings. Then you put the, use the medium hard brush with dark ink to the feather and the dots. I use a light ink to the stomach. So this is a blind. This one standing with a crawling on something. So now I'm going to add the little branch. This can be a bamboo or can be any branch. Maybe it's a little bamboo branch. Branch. Since I have a little branch, little bamboo branch is standing on, so I draw a little bit of the bamboo too. Which the next session I'm going to start doing the bamboo. just do very simple composition. Simple composition to combine the birds with the bamboo. Thank you.
I just show you the two little birds. I hope you all like it and you all have a good time. And next time, we're going to start doing something more serious. That's what I call them, the gentlemen of the four gentlemen, which is bamboo. Same thing, it's, I'm going to divide up in two sessions. First time introduce the bamboo structure and then some very basic stroke about the leaves and the branches. And the next session I'm going to introduce following the how to do the ink style, the stem. And then I'm going to do the bamboos in the ink only and in color too. Thank you.